nothing anybody can do. Even the Spirit himself cannot convince you to hear a message from God through that person. And that's what happens to a number of people. And you see, we need to be very careful. We need to live by what? The Spirit. When you live by the Spirit, you will only speak like God, speak the will of God, being judgmental. Listen, you know the Bible says don't judge another person. Being judgmental is when you are speaking what you perceive as truth from the flesh. From what?
The flesh.
I'm taking it. From what? When you are speaking what you perceive as truth from the flesh, that's when you begin to judge. But when you are speaking what is the truth by the Spirit, that's not judgment. And this is where many people miss it. You say, you are judging me. And you come to tell somebody, look, the way you are living is not of God. Repent. You say, you are judging me. You want to show me you are better than me. Now, if you are doing it by the flesh, you are condemning that person without the Holy Ghost guiding. But if you are doing it by the Holy Spirit, it is not judgment. And this is where a number of people say, the Bible says, judge not. However, Jesus Christ has said it to all the Jews, you hypocrites. The same Jesus said, except you repent, you shall likewise what? Perish. Did you hear me? A number of people do not know the scripture. And so they tell you, don't judge me. But sin must always be condemned. And if we begin to shy away from condemning sin, then we do not have the Spirit of God again. Because the Spirit himself always will contend with sin and carnal living. Praise the Lord. Alright, we talk about emotion that stops us. Most times, let me ask us, what does God expect that when you are considering things, are you going to start looking at it from what benefits you from the flesh, or how God sees it? Can anybody answer the question? Do you hear the question? When you want to make a decision, when you look at, is it what benefits you, gives you comfort, or how God himself is pleased? What pleases the Spirit? Which one is supposed to be? But what is it that we usually do?
What pleases us?
First of all. And this is where we are failing. We are failing. So in most time, living by the Spirit is dash. A, easy. B, not easy. Which one is it?
Not easy.
B.
B, not easy. Okay. To live by the Spirit. A is a must. B, God understands we can be excused. Which one is it?
The A.
What is the A?
A must.
It's a must. Now, why is it that many of us make excuses? Oh well, God understands. God is not going to kill me. I am at least a little better than others. I lived in the Spirit last year for 40%. There are people who lived in the Spirit for 2%. At least God will pass me. Because it's not a question of standard pass. It's a question of the graph. When God draws the graph and find that I am the champion in the dungeon, then he will tell me, come to heaven. God doesn't do that. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The thing about the Holy Spirit is not by chance. know, if you take, if 40, if 100 people take an exam, and the exam was tough, they will do a chart. With everybody score 20% and below, you may say, okay, anyone who score from 15% to 20 pass, God doesn't do like that. You don't. And it's not also that everybody, you do exam, most people score 190. God say, okay, because it's so high, the standard is not 100, only those who pass on it. It's not like that. There's one standard. It's not by chance. That's something I say, there's no graphing in heaven. So in case you know mathematics and you want to make graph and chart, it's not. Living by the Spirit is a must. Praise the Lord. To live by the Spirit is what? It's a must. And it is the identity of those who are. Praise the Lord. Can we look at, we are doing some scripture. Open your Bible and check the place where one woman was supposed to be stoned to death. And Jesus did not. Does it mean that Jesus condoned fornication or adultery?
No.
It doesn't mean that. God, Jesus does not. Amen?
Amen.
Why did Jesus tell those people, anyone of you who first, those of you, anyone who will deny of being, you know, of being clean, let the person first strike. Amen?
Amen.
Why did Jesus do that? Let's see that woman. Do we know where it is?
It's in the book of John.
The woman caught in adultery.
John.
Yes, somebody said somewhere in John. That's why I want you to start the scripture. Search your scriptures. Open the Bible. That's why you have concordance. Don't come.
John chapter 8.
John chapter 8. Come, read for us where they brought the woman.
You want me to read where it says John 8, 7. So when they continued asking him, he lifted up his own and asked,
no.
He that is without whatever.
They brought, just when they brought the woman and said she committed adultery.
Oh, okay. Okay. No, verse 3. And the scribes of the Pharisees brought unto him a woman taken in adultery. And when they had set her in the midst, they say unto him, Master, this woman was taken in adultery in the very act.
Okay.
Continue. And now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned. But what sayest thou? This they say, tempting him that they might have to accuse him. But Jesus stood down and with his finger wrote on the ground as though he heard them not. So when they continued asking him, he lifted up himself and said unto them, he that is without sin among you, let him first cast a stone at her. And again he stood down and wrote on the ground. And they which heard it, being convicted by their own conscience, went out one by one, beginning at the eldest, even unto the last. And Jesus was left alone, and the woman standing in the midst. And Jesus, when Jesus had lifted up himself and saw none but the woman, he said unto her, Woman, where are those thine accusers? Had no man condemned thee? She said, No man, Lord. And Jesus said unto her, Neither do I condemn thee. Go and sin no more.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Do you see the difference between a man in the spirit and those who are judging from the flesh? Now, in the flesh, you condemn to destruction. In the spirit, you speak to salvation. Are we getting what I'm saying? Are you seeing the difference? Now they came up. Jesus didn't ask them, go and bring the man. Let's talk about it. But the woman could not be taken for adultery in the act masturbating. That's not. The woman was committing the sin with another person. Jesus didn't tell them because that was not the issue. The issue is that in the flesh, they the principles of the word of God. That's what it means to live by the Spirit. Jesus said, the word I speak to you, it is spirit and it is what? Life. Praise the Lord. There's a contrast between living